Family, friends, neighbors, even strangers who came to know Jeter all said the same thing about her. She's the best dog ever.
Cute.
Jeter joined the O'Neill family in the summer of 2004, a reward for our daughter Samantha's good grades in school. Samantha did a story about her new puppy on WXII 12 News.
Looks like Jeter and I have got a lot of work to do. She doesn't even know her own name yet, but I'm going to teach her because she's my puppy and I love her.
We didn't know it then, but Samantha had picked a winner. I got the naming rights. I chose Jeter after the family's favorite baseball player, Derek Jeter, former shortstop for the New York Yankees and Greensboro Hornets.
Come, Jeter.
Good job.
Good job.
By next summer, Samantha and her puppy Jeter were back on TV. This time, a story on dog training.
Good girl. Good job.
Besides her role as a TV star, Jeter had another job at home. Each morning, she brought me the newspaper. When she reached retirement age a few years ago, she stopped bringing me the paper, instead waiting for someone else to get it. Meeting them at the front door, she'd grab it and wait for her treat before giving it up.
You know, Lab, they love chewing up everything. Look, we can't even put cushions on the chairs. Not any of the chairs. You know why? Because Jeter chews everything.
As a puppy, her only fault was chewing up everything in sight, which led to her next TV story with Samantha. Visiting a dog whisperer.
It's a big stuffed animal, in her point of view.
What made Jeter the best dog ever was her personality. She never barked, didn't jump on people. She only wanted two things, be around family and hope that they would give her a treat. Jeter went where we went, did what we did, and often ate what we ate. Every Sunday morning, she'd have pancakes, not someone's leftovers. I made a pancake just for her every Sunday. She was part of the family's annual Christmas card picture. And as our family grew, Jeter welcomed the grandkids with the same patience and kindness as always. The kids came to love Jeter just like the rest of us.
Most days around 5 o'clock, Jeter would be at the curb waiting for our neighbor, Jimmy, to come home from work and give her a treat. Everyone in the neighborhood knew Jeter. Most of them thought we had an electric fence in the yard because Jeter was never chained up. We didn't have an electric fence because Jeter wasn't going anywhere. She was home with her family, exactly where she wanted to be. She was the best dog ever, and we're going to miss her.